How data is powering business and transforming industries today?
I think there's a variety of great examples. Certainly, companies use a lot of analytics, so they look at the data and they make decisions based on that. But more and more we also see that companies are operationalizing things, meaning that they automatically act on that data. And there's so many great examples where companies are also using data based on sensors and instrumentation, and it's also referred to as the Internet of Things. But we see companies like elevator companies looking at how many times do their elevators run, and then based on that they change the maintenance schedule and they maintain their products when it's needed, not when it's scheduled, saving millions of dollars.
During your presentation, you said that only 4% of companies are part of the, what you call, informate elite. I'm wondering why is that, and if you are thinking somehow all the companies are going to join this very small group.
Yeah, so why only 4%? Well, who gets everything right? That's part of it. But there's just so much more opportunity. If you look at the parts of the business processes that are really truly instrumented today, how many systems companies are running and how much data they actually have a view into, there's just so much room for improvement. And a lot of companies are doing a great job in one area, but are they doing a great job end-to-end throughout their business? Every one of us has a lot of room for improvement, and fact is that a lot of the functions in companies are still not really working together as well as they could. So look at marketing and support, just to pick one example. So much of the support data is very helpful to marketing. So if you know which customers are doing well, you can do better analysis on churn, you can do analysis around propensity to buy, propensity to, for churn, and you can act on that as a marketer. So by us bringing all the data together and doing a better job across the board, it just opens so much opportunity. So very many companies today, unfortunately, they still have stovepipes, they have silos, they have applications that aren't talking to each other. So that's just the reality of today. And now, to just make sure that everyone isn't freaked out about it, the technology has evolved quite a bit, and it's easier today than ever to do something about it, to connect the different applications and to really bring the data together and then analyze it in new ways with big data. So, you know, part of it is some of the technology wasn't available, but now that it is, it's like, let's get on with it.
And part of it is kind of a lack of process inside companies. And you also mentioned professional skills. Do you think these three, this triple, like technology, process, and professionals need to work together in order to make further with all this data analysis?
Yeah, it's not just the technology. So it really is three things that you always have to keep in balance. It's the technology, it's the skill sets, and it's also the processes. So if a company doesn't have the right skills, you need to either train the people or hire some of the people who really understand technology and can work with data-driven technologies. But then you also need to make sure you have the right processes so that you act on the data, you collect the data properly, you have quality data. And without process, you get inconsistent results. And with inconsistent results, you get bad data, you can make bad decisions, and you're also not going to be able to get the most out of the data, meaning being able to then also predict outcomes in the future based on the history. So bottom line is, you got to balance those three. You got to have the technology, that's the foundation, but then having the right skill sets, either training people or bringing new people in, and then running processes that operationalize everything and create consistency. Those three things are key, and it is a tripod. It is a three-legged stool, and that's just the way it works.
How are Brazilian companies doing in this field?
I've seen a number of great examples, and one of my favorites is Croton, and they are such an amazing company. And you know, if you think about the educational market is tremendous. It's just huge, but Croton is the biggest company in that space worldwide on three dimensions. It's not just the number of students, it's the market cap, it's the revenue they're driving, and they're aggressive. They're just in the process of making another acquisition, and behind all that is a really great data strategy. They have their students in an MDM system so that they have a complete view into everything that they're doing with the student. So it's just a really great leading example, and I hope that they can take that even further and get more business value out of it, because it's such a great foundation.